are people shooting at each other up there now. This is serious.
But in the desert, where there's been this kind of Wild West mentality, a sort of free-for-all mentality.
This is up in an area known as Desert Heights, which we have renamed Desert Frights, because four families have moved out of there because of the effects of the off-road vehicles, because of the threats, because of the killing of the animals.
I have been run off the road by dirt bikes and quads while walking down our road and other roads. They don't respect us.
I threatened, harassed, knocked down, and had rocks thrown at me.
She found them down the street, in the road, with ORV tracks over both bodies. Both dogs were not able to be saved. They're dead.
I began to see children riding on paved streets, several times without helmets.
That's been expected for years, that people should be allowed to do that, to even come.
I didn't even want to go outside in the mornings or enjoy the evenings, because that's all I could hear was three strokes up and down my road. And
our tax dollars already pay for off-roaders to go to a designated area. Our areas, our desert areas, are under siege.
That's hilariously funny.
I was terrorized by, and I hate to use that word, but they really were coming roaring through my property at all hours.
Not on her property. She came home the next day. Her dog had a bullet hole between its eyes, a rope around its neck, and no flesh, skin, or hair on the underside where it had been dragged down the road.
The cost to the desert is irreparable.
My life has been anything but tranquil.
There was three strokes up and down my road. And
I have been sandblasted, and I wish I had brought pictures. I have pictures of sand 12 feet above me.
I'm a retired National Park Service ranger.
I mean, that's it. Yeah.